Hello guys, my name is Khan, and in today's video, I will give you four examples of data relationship. So the first thing is, what is meant by data relationship? So in order to go into detail about the relationship between data set, I have created few examples. So I will go along with this example, these examples. So these examples will be easily able to tell you what does it mean by relationship between the dataset. So I have this, as you can see, I am in the Excel sheet which I have constructed for you guys to show data relationships. So this is my data one, which is suppose I have conducted some survey in a household and I have asked each household three questions, and you can see that there are four households. But in this data, the ID is a kind of a key variable, whereas in data 2, I have asked further three questions to the same household, as you can see, to the same four household. So the relationship between data 1 and data 2 is 1-to-1. What does it mean by 1-to-1 relationship? That there is, if there is a one row in data 1 is corresponding to the one row to data 2. Again, for household ID 2, there is one row which is in data 1, and there is also one row in data 2. So this kind of relationship is named as 1-to-1 relationship, when there is a one row in one data set is corresponding to another row which is in some other data set, then it's named as 1-to-1 relationship between data set. So I will take you guys to Power BI, and I will show you that how Power BI come to know that there is a 1-to-1 relationship between data sets or not. So I will go to my search, I will search for Power BI and I will double click it. So for this video, I will just copy the data and I will paste it into Power BI. This is also a way of importing the data into Power BI, especially if you are dealing with smaller data sets. So I will go to this, I will be closing it, and I will say enter data, and I will just control V. So it is, as it's written down here, the first row of the data that you pasted has been promoted as the column header, which is fine. I'm calling it table 1. You can rename it if you want, but I think table 1 for me is fine. I will say load. So it's loading the data set in Power BI. Meanwhile, I will also copy my second data set. Copy. And as you can see, that table 1, my data 1 got imported successfully. Now again, I can click this enter data option and I will say control V. This is my second data set. Table 2 is fine. Okay, so again it's loading. So the loading of table 1 and table 2 is complete. You can see the variable names under table 2 is question 4, 5, 6. But here currently we are in a report window, whereas this is my data window where I can see the data set. And here is the relationships. All the data that I imported, Power BI automatically realized that the relationship between table 1 and table 2 is, here it is written on 1 and here it's written on 1. It's meaning that the relationship between 1-to-1. If I hover my cursor over this 1-to-1 line, you can see it highlight the variable based on these data sets are related. So it's again saying that the one row in table 1 is based on household ID. There is one row in table 1, and this same ID also have one row in table 2. But suppose if you have two data sets and there is no relationship, if the Power BI is not showing any relationship, you can simply click that variable in the table 1 and you can drag it to the table 2, and it will automatically realize the relationship between
and between two tables. So it's all, so once I drag the variable from table 1 to table 2, it's pop up with the thing that there is already a relationship between these two columns. So okay, but if you find that Power BI, sometimes when you will be dealing with larger number of columns, sometimes Power BI will not be able to figure out based on which variable there is a relationship between the two tables, then you can drag the variable towards the other table or query table column that which have the relationship. So why is it important to have define a relationship between data set? So in order to highlight the importance of this relationship, so suppose if you are working in Power BI and suppose if you are creating a table and you want to show the results of question number 2, which is in table 1, and you also want to add question number 5, which is in table 2, you can do that if in the same table you can call both of these variables if there is a relationship between table 1 and 2. So let's give you an example. So suppose we have insert a table. So, and let's see if I insert my household IDs, and if I also add question number 2, and now I can also add question number 5. This thing is happening because both tables have a relationship between each other. That's why within the same table, it's allowing me to add variables from multiple data sets. So as you can see in this table, we have inserted question number 2, which is in table 1, and question number 5, which is in other table coming from table 2. So that's why it's very important to have a relationship between tables. So once you have a relationship between tables, you can add each other columns more freely into your graphs or into your tables that you are doing in Power BI. So before moving further, I will just for ease, I will delete this table so that for my other examples, you don't get confused. Delete, because my other example will not much have to do with these tables. And now I will return back to my Excel sheet. So currently I have highlighted how you can build a one-to-one relationship in tables. And now I will give you an example of one-to-many relationship. First I will show what is means by one-to-many relationship. So I have this example for you guys. So in my data tree, you can see that I have some household IDs, 4 household IDs. I have their country information, which is USA for all household. And then I have state information for all household. But on my data 4, what I have asked us questions to in each household, but at a member level. So suppose I went to each house, I asked the questions to multiple members of that household. So you can see that for household ID, I have 3 rows in which I have asked member ID 1, 2 and 3, the question number 1, 2 and 3 and their responses. And for household ID 2, I have 2, the household ID 2 is coming twice. And then I have asked 2 members of that household 3 questions each. And again, there are 1 member for household ID 3 and household ID 4. But here, the important thing to note that between data 3 and data 4, the 1 household ID have multiple observations in data 4. For household ID 3, you can see that there is only 1 corresponding row for in data 4. But there are cases, especially for question for household ID 2 and 1, there are multiple rows in corresponding to that household. So these kind of relationships are known as a one-to-many relationships. Now I will take you guys back to Power BI. So again, I will copy my data 3. I will copy it and I'll go to Power BI. I will say enter data. And I will paste it here. I will, for my ease, I will call it data 3. Load it. Meanwhile, it's loading. I will copy my data 4. Copy. As you can see, data 3 got uploaded successfully. Again, I will enter data here. I will control V here again. Okay. And I will change it to data 4. I will say load it. So it's loading my data 4 now. And as you can see, data 4 also got loaded. So let's go to my relationship window, which is on the left side. So you can see here the data 3 have written down 1, which is mean that for each household ID there is one row in data 3, whereas here in for data 4 there is static sign here, which is showing that for one row in how in data 3 there could be multiple rows in data 4 and the relationship is based on household ID. Again, if you are dealing with the data and if Power BI unable to recognize the relationship between data set, you can simply come to that variable and you can drag it to the other variable which are having the relationship, and the Power BI will realize the relationship between those data set. Again, if I go to my report window and if I suppose again insert a table, and again I suppose if I select my state variable and from data 4 if I select my question number 1, so you can see that the state is coming from data 3 whereas the question 1 is coming from data 4. So because there is a relationship in these two data sets, that's why you can use data variables from different data sets into one table or in one graph. And in this example, I've shown that these data set have one to many relationship. So before moving further again, I will delete these data set because I don't want to confuse you guys with so many data set in Power BI. So I will delete it here. Delete here again. So now I'll take you guys back to the Excel where I have created example. But the point here is to notice that in my both of my the example that I have given to you guys till now, that the data sets have one to one or one to many relationship is based on singular variable. But suppose if there is a relationship between data set based on multiple variables. So I have created one example. So in the first example, I'm saying even that there is a one-to-one relationship based on two variables. So what does it mean? So suppose you have a data set. So we have state variable, and then within the state we have town, and then we have measured the population for the given town. So as you can see that the state one have town number 1 which have this population, whereas the state 1 also have a town 2 which have this population, and in the same way state 2 and state 3. So here, but in my second data set, my data 6, you can see that again we have state 1 and town 1 which have the death rate of 10, and again for town 2 of state 1 is this. So if you notice here, the relationship between data 5 and data 6 is based on two variables, state town, and again in data 6 state town. So state town, so 1 is having one row corresponding to one row in data 5. For this row 1 2, so this town of the given state have a one row in data 6. So these kind of data sets have one to one relationship but based on two variables. So this is a very important concept. So what I will do first to show you guys that how you can create relationship between such kind of data sets in Power BI. It's very easy, but you have to play around a bit. The technique that I usually use, I will tell you guys about that, but there are several other techniques, but I think the technique that I will teach you guys is very simple. So what I will do again, I will copy this data, take you to the Power BI, and I will enter data and Control V, and I will call it for my East data file. Load. So you can see data 5 is here. I will copy data 6 to copy. Enter data again. Control V. Again, I will call it data 6. Load. So as you can see, data 5 and data 6 got loaded. Again, if I go to my relationship model, so let's see. Here you can see that Power BI unable to recognize the relationship between data 5 and data 4, because here the relationship is based on multiple variables. So based on state and town, we can build a one-to-one relationship with data 6. So in order to do that, what I will do, I will take you guys to edit queries, because I will create an ID variable which will be coming based on state 2 and which will based on state and town. So what I will do for my ease, because I will be using concatenate function. I think if you have used concatenate function in Excel, but there is no need to worry. What I will do, you just have to follow these steps which I will do. So what I will do first, as you can see, the state is numeric. I don't want to be considered as numeric. So if you are using a variable which is already a string, then you don't have to be worried. But for me, it's not string. What I will do, I will click here and I will make it as a text, even though it's having, I will say, replace current data type. So as you can see, it's changed to the string. Again, for the state to for the town to, I will make it text. So yes, replace the current data type. So both of the variables are now string. So now what I will do, I will add a column, and I will say custom column, and I will name it as ID. You can name it whatever you want. And after that, I will be saying the state, and want to combine, so I will be using and within the state. And no need to worry if you are not getting what I'm doing. Once the result will be done, you will be able to see very easy what I have done. State and my next variable down, double click it. So here is the tick sign, it's meaning the syntax is working fine. I will say okay. So now what I have done, I have created an ID. And what you have done is that it have taken the first part from my state, then added a comma, and then have combined the town. So 1, 1, 1, 2. So now I have both the state and town information in the same variable. So in the same way, even if there is a relationship between data set based on more than two variables, you can create an ID variable in Power BI by using the same technique. So I have created, the important thing to note here is that I have created a ID variable in data 5. So I have to repeat the same step for data 6. I will go to data 6. So now I'm in data 6. Again, I will change the data type here to text for state. And I will do the same thing for town 2. So here I am getting a pop-up, the change column type. It means that you want to change the existing column type. I will say yes, replace the current data type. So both of them, state and town, got into string now. I'm actually converting the string, because if I will not do that, the function that I'm using will get an error. because the formula that I'm using to create an ID variable is valid when the columns are the strings. And again, I will go to add column, custom column. I will call it as ID. Again, I will be calling my state variable first. Then I will say and, then inverted commas. Within inverted comma, I will be using comma. Then and, and down variable. Okay. So now you can see again we have an ID variable which is now capturing both the state and the town information within the same ID. So before leaving the query window, I will say close and apply, close and apply. So everything got applied. So it's applying my changes to, and now once I created a variable, you can see if you hover around of this line, you can see that Power BI automatically realized that there is a relationship between data 5 and data 6 is based on ID variable. So once we have built a relationship, now if I go to my report window, if I add a state, close it down, I will create a data table. If I add a state, and I will add a population, and then I, based on table 5, 6, I can add. So that here we have already a state 2. You can see now that here we have added variables from data 5 and data 6 into the same table. This thing come to happen because we're able to build a relationship between these two tables. And in this example, the relationship between data 5 and data 6 is based on two variables, not just one variable. But then we manipulated the data in a way where we created one variable based on which we can able to configure the relationship between data 5 and data 6. And again, before going towards my other example, I will delete. First, I will delete this table. I will delete these load dataset because I will be importing again more datasets into Power BI for my next example. Delete. Again, I will take you guys back to my last example. So now in my last example, I will show you guys that how you can do one-to-many relationship between data set. So again, here the example is very much the similar to my previous example. So we have data 7 and data 8. In data 7, I have one row for each state and town. So for state 1, town 1, I have one row, whereas state 1, 2, is for state 1, there is a town 2. It also have one row in data 7, but in data 8, for state 1, I have about 5 rows, and for each row I have corresponding town. And here you can see that the town is repeating multiple times, even here too, for the given state, because here we have state and town level information, whereas here I have the information at the state level, then town level and the household level. So here we have the information at a household level in a given town, in a given state. So here you can see that one row of this data can correspond to multiple rows in data A. So that's why you have a one-to-many relationship in between data 7 and data 8. And again, the relationship is based on multiple variables here. So what I will do, I will quickly copy this data to Power BI. I will click it here to data. And Control B. Table 1, load. So table 1 got loaded into Power BI. Again, I will take table 2. This is data 8. Copy. Let's enter data. Control V. Table 2. Load. So once the loading is done, I will quickly go to my relationship window. You can see that the Power BI unable to recognize again that there is a relationship between these two tables based on state town variables. So again, I will take you guys to edit queries. I will quickly create ID variable in table 1, but before I will change the data type again. Text, yes, replace grant for town 2. And now once these two variables got converted into string variable, now I can combine them. I will go to add columns, then custom column. I will create a I variable ID. And my ID will be based on state and sign. And then I will say comma. Then and sign again. And then my second variable based on which my ID variable is based. Okay. I have created an ID variable in that table 1. I will repeat the same step for table 2. Before moving further, I will convert the state into text variable. Replace grant. I will do the same for town 2. Replace grant. And now I will add a column, custom column. I will name it as ID. I will be using this ID variable based on these two variables, state and town. This is state. And down and down. Okay, so now you can see that I have also an ID variable in table 2. So before leaving a query window, I will go to home. I will say close and apply the changes to this dataset. So under my relationship window, you can see that probably Power BI. Here you can see that Power BI automatically realized that there is a relationship between these two tables now, and the relationship between these two tables is one to many. So there is a one row in table 1 which is corresponding to many rows in table 2. If there is a one to many relationship, there is a static sign showing that there are many rows in table 2 which are corresponding to one row in table 1. So again, before finishing, if I insert a table here, and if I suppose in my table 2, you can see that suppose if I insert a state variable in a column, then if I want to also add population and within the state, and I can also use question number 2. So you can see that multiple variables are coming from different data set, but I am using those variables within the same segment of my graph or table. So before finishing this video, I will quickly tell you guys that what we have covered. We have covered that how you can build one-to-one relationship between data set based on singular variable. Then I have covered how you can build one to many relationship between two data set based on again singular variable, and then we have discussed how you can create one to one relationship between variable based on multiple variables, and then I also have covered that how you can build a relationship between data set one to many relationship between data set again based on multiple variable, not based on just singular variable. Thank you for watching the video.